Hello everyone, hi, welcome to the channel of Wall Street Mojo.
Watch the video till the end, and also if you are new to this channel, then you can subscribe us by clicking the bell icon.
Friends, today we have a topic which is preferred dividend. Well, preferred dividend is a fixed dividend that is received from the preferred stock. Now this is what we call an in definition, but we'll try to get into the nitty-gritty of this particular topic. What does this exactly mean? See, it means that if you are, let's say, a preferred shareholder, or I'll just write over here as PS, you would get a fixed percentage of dividend every year. I repeat, every year. It's like a fixed interest sort. And the most of the beneficial part of this preferred stock is that, you know, the preferred shareholders gets a higher rate of dividend. So they are also given, you know, you can say more preference than equity shareholders in terms of the dividend payment. Now look at this screenshot over here. This is a Dyna Shipping Company, the dividend history preference shares on the NYSE, that New York Stock Exchange. You see 0.3759 and so on and so forth. It's somewhere it is constant. So this is how the dividend are being paid. There was just this extract was just an example to show you how exactly things work. But there is a very simple formula for calculating the preferred dividend on the preferred stock. Preferred dividend is equal to what we say value into rate of dividend into the number of preferred share. So this is going to be for the preferred dividend. Now if the preferred shareholders wants to, let's say, invest in the preferred stock, so they need to look at what we call as prospectus. Now if the preferred shareholders wants to invest, they need to have prospectus. They need two basic things. Now what is the two basic things? The first one is, what is the value of the stock? And second thing, what is the rate of dividend? Now once they know that there's two basic things, they can simply multiply this two component and can understand how much they would receive at the end of each year. So the great advantage of investing in preferred stock is that it is like a fixed instrument. It's like a fixed instrument, and you are assured of the what we call as the fixed payment every plus, you know, if the firm gets bankrupt, let's say if the firm gets bankrupt any day, you will be given preference over the equity shareholders. And it means that, you know, if a company becomes bankrupt before equity shareholders are paid back, you will get the amount due to you. So you don't need to worry, your money is in the safe. The equity shareholders will be the one last. So once you know how to calculate the preferred dividend per share, you would just need to what we call as multiply number of shares with the preferred dividend that has been the dividend per share. So, and you would know how much each year you would get Now let's take an example of the preferred dividend formula so that, you know, convert this theoretical data into some practical numbers. So let's take a simple example to see, you know, how preferred dividend is calculated. Let's say there's a person called Ursula has invested in, let's say, the preferred stock of a firm. And as the prospectus says, she will get a preferred dividend of 8% of the par value of the stock, or par value of the shares, actually, not the stock. Stock would be an incorrect word. The par value of, you know, over here, each share is, let's say, standing at $100. And Ursula has bought, let's say, 1,000 of such preferred stock. So how much the preferred dividend she will get each year or every year? The basic two things to calculate the preferred dividend, you know, they are given right in front of us. So we know that the rate of dividend and also the par value of each stock. So by using the preferred dividend formula, we get par value into the rate of dividend into the number of preferred stock. Well, this should be simple. 100 into 8% into number of shares, that's 1,000. So $8,000. It means every year Ursula will get $8,000 as preferred dividend. Now let's understand some of the common features of what we call as preferred dividend. The first is higher dividend rates. See, preferred dividends are much higher than the rate of equity common stock. So the reason for this, because the preference shareholders do not have the ownership, you can say, control over the company. Hence, to attract the investors, a higher dividend are offered to them. Second, there is a fixed percentage. So unlike the dividend or common or equity stock, which keeps on fluctuating every year depending on the profitability ratios of the company, you can say the preferred dividends do not fluctuate their rate, and their rate remains unchanged throughout the maturity life of the preference shares. Third, there is also one major reason for the fluctuation of the dividend, the common stock. So dividend rates on the common stocks, they are recommended by the shareholders and during the annual general meetings of the company. Hence, you know, it keeps on fluctuating since, you know, the shareholder decides the rates, keeping in mind the profitability and the future outlook of the company. Let's understand the feature as the cumulative or arrears of dividend. Now, one of the important feature of the preferred dividend is that, you know, shareholders, they are entitled to preferred dividend every year, irrespective of the profitability of the company. But sometime, what exactly happens, you know, on account of the business contingencies or on the business exigencies, a company may not be in a position to pay its shareholders. So in such circumstances, the dividends, they are accumulated and are paid in the subsequent year. So let's understand the impact of one of the business exigencies on the payment of the preference dividend with the help of practical illustration. Let's say there's a company called Company X, which has, let's say, 3 million outstanding 5% preferred shares as on 31st of December 2016. Now, the par value of the preferred shares is, let's say, standing at 10 each, and the cash balance available with the company is, let's say, $1 million. So the preference dividend to be paid for the year 2015 has to be 3 million, right, into 10 into 5. We need to close the bracket. That will be divided by, in total, 100. Just divide this by 100. So that is it, 1.5 million. That's the available, that's the preferred dividend to be paid. And the available, let's say, cash balance is only 1 million. So I'll just write 1. So in the above case, it's not possible for the company. The dividend to be paid is 1.5 million. Available cash is 1. So it is not possible for the company to pay the preferred dividend to the shareholders, since, you know, the total available cash is completely less than the total amount of the preferred dividend lab. Since the dividend are always paid, you know, in cash, its shortage will force the company to withhold the payments of the dividend for the year 2016. So in the above case, you know, the dividend will get accumulated and must eventually be paid to preferred shareholders in the subsequent financial year. Well, that's it for this particular topic. For the preferred dividend, we have discussed the example formula and some of the features.
So that's it for this particular topic. If you have learned and enjoyed watching this video, please like and comment on this video and subscribe to our channel for the latest updates. Thank you, everyone. Cheers.